If you want to learn the push-ups, inverted rows, dips, pull-ups with perfect form, the fastest and most efficient way, not to mention the advanced moves like handstand, planche, front lever, etc., then you need to work on one thing for sure, the scapula stability. This is the secret key to the super strong upper body and to learn all the exercises I mentioned. The opportunity is there, and how you can achieve all these, I'm gonna explain it to you in this video. What's up guys, it's Adam from gymnasticsmethod.com. If you don't want to miss my videos about bodyweight training and lifestyle, please subscribe and click on the bell. Thank you. And if you want to get access to all the Gymnastics Method workout programs, tutorials like planche, handstand or muscle up, nutrition guide, daily workouts and much more, click the link below and become a member now on gymnasticsmethod.com. So, scapula stability. This is the area of the body that most people have never heard of, or if they have so, they probably skipped it because scapulas are not muscles and you can't gain them. That's true. The scapula is not a muscle, it's a bone. Part of the shoulder joint, it connects with the clavicule and the humerus. But then why is your scapula important? The scapulas are the connection points between your trunk and your arms. There are several muscles connected to each scapula. The proper scapula position is key in different exercises for the most efficient muscle contractions, and it affects your gains. The proper mobility and stability are really important in various pulling and pushing exercises, as well as in exercises done in support or hanging. First of all, the proper mobility and range of motion are keys, and then the stabilization, strengthening in all those dimensions. If you know the movements of your scapulas and you can apply the proper positions in different exercises, you can ensure your continuous progression and you can prevent injuries. The bad position of the scapulas is a common reason of shoulder injuries because you can put your joint in a bad position, not to mention the injury of the muscles that are connected to the scapula. So, as you can see, not the scapula bone itself, but the movements of the scapula are the keys and its positions in different exercises. We can describe the shoulder movements with the movements of the scapulas easily and clearly. Let's see the movements of the scapula. The shoulder blade is capable of six movements, which are the following: elevation, depression, adduction, abduction, upward rotation, and downward rotation. If you have never tried these scapula movements, as a first step, you should do these isolations in order to build the neuromuscular connections and have full control of the movements. An effective way to do that is to raise your arms in front of your body and do the elevations and depressions, adductions and abductions. If you can do these with confidence, you will be able to connect them to a circular motion, forward and backward. Then you can do the same thing in kneeling support. This is a really good way to move around your scapulas as the part of the warm-up. You can do the upward and downward rotations with switched S-shaped arm positions, which are also good for shoulder mobilization. In bodyweight training, calisthenics or street workout, the most important movements are the elevation, depression, adduction, abduction and their combination. As I mentioned in one of my previous videos, these scapula exercises have two-in-one mobilization and stabilization effect. Thanks to the concentric and eccentric phases, we can move and strengthen these movements in the biggest possible range of motion between the upper and lower endpoints. As we do these exercises, the range of motion can increase as well as we become stronger. There are examples of both cases. If someone is hypermobile, it's possible to stabilize the joints and strengthen the muscles, increase the muscle tone, and if someone has tight shoulders, it's possible to stretch the muscles and increase the range of motion. Let's see some specific examples for the scapula stabilization exercises. First of all, as the very basic, I'd like to mention the scapula push-ups. In this exercise, you need to do active scapula abduction and passive scapula adduction with depressed shoulders, locked elbows, tight core and posterior pelvic tilt. This exercise strengthens your shoulders and stabilizes your scapulas greatly for the scapula movements during any push-up variations or any pushing exercise in the horizontal plane. Not to mention that the upper endpoint of the scapula push-ups is the key, the first step for the planche, since there you have to maintain depressed and abducted scapulas as well. The next exercise is the scapula adduction in hanging, or if you want to do it on the floor without any equipment, in real push-up position. Here, you need to do the opposite of the previous exercise, so depress and adduct your scapulas with locked elbows and tight core. With these exercises, you can strengthen the first phase of the inverted rows or Australian pull-ups, the scapula activation. This movement helps your pull-ups as well if you want to do them with perfect implementation in full range of motion. To be able to touch the bar with your chest, this movement is essential. An example of this scapula movement from the advanced moves is the front lever. There, you need to strive for the depressed and adducted scapulas, even if it's mostly impossible to maintain because of the unfavorable mechanical position. The next important movement is the scapula depression that you can do in support or hanging. Both are recommended. For the stable supported positions on the P-bars or rings, for the dips, the scapula depression in support is a very important basic. In the beginning, you can do them with leg support, then you can remove the legs. The scapula depression in hanging is not only important for the perfect pull-ups, but it also improves your grip strength. Besides that, contrary to the popular belief, hanging is not bad for your elbows, wrists or shoulders. Actually, it's the opposite. It really helps to decompress and relieve the joints, not to mention the spine. Returning to the exercise itself, it's really important to do this exercise in a decent range of motion because you can have more control and muscle activation to improve your pull-ups and any pulling exercise in the vertical plane, even if it's the regular pull-up or the muscle-up. With only this exercise, you can fix the most common mistakes that people do, not doing pull-ups in full range of motion, which is the most important reasons why they can't learn the muscle-up. After all these, you can see that learning and strengthening the scapula movements are essential in calisthenics. If you want to follow along a complete program that focuses on the preparation of the whole body, including the proper scapula movements, and want to know all the exercises with the proper sets and reps, tested and proven by thousands of people, click the link below and join now on gymnasticsmethod.com. In the Primal 1 program, you can prepare the whole body to the basics and the advanced calisthenics and gymnastics skills. Besides that, on gymnasticsmethod.com, you can find a complete, easy-to-follow guidance to master any skills you want from scratch. All you need to do is to click the link below and join right now. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did so, please like, share, and write a comment what do you want to see in the next videos. Subscribe if you haven't already and click on the bell for more. See you next Friday at 3 p.m. Eastern Time.